A dusty opportunity spotted on Mars, hot firing the rocket engine that will power us to deep space, and a visit with our newest class of astronaut candidates. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. A high-resolution camera aboard our Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter spotted our Opportunity rover still on the slopes of the Martian Valley it was descending when a massive dust storm struck more than 100 days ago. The rover team has not heard from the solar-powered rover since a lack of sunlight from the storm caused it to go into hibernation, but they continue to send commands to Opportunity in hopes that the rover will respond. On September 25th, engineers at our Stennis Space Center in Mississippi successfully conducted the third in a series of scheduled RS-25 rocket engine hot fire tests for our Space Launch System Program, or SLS. The hot fire tested several key elements, including a flight controller that will help the engine communicate with the SLS rocket. SLS will use four RS-25s to launch our Orion spacecraft on missions to deep space destinations, including the Moon and Mars.
There's a lot of really exciting things happening at NASA.
On September 27th at NASA headquarters, our Administrator Jim Bridenstine talked with the newest class of astronaut trainees about their experiences in the training program, hopes for future missions, and more during a live episode of Watch This Space.
What excites you the most about going to space?
I think humanity is kind of driven by curiosity and the want to explore. And so to be able to represent that is a pretty neat privilege.
This is a dream that's shared by thousands of people. And we're just the lucky ambassadors that have the opportunity to fulfill this mission.
Once their training is complete, the astronaut candidates may be assigned to missions that range from performing research on the International Space Station to launching from American soil on spacecraft built by U.S. commercial companies to departing for deep space missions on our SLS rocket and Orion spacecraft. You can learn more about the newest astronaut candidates at nasa.gov/2017astronauts. Also on September 27th, the crew of the International Space Station received more than 5 tons of supplies, spare parts, and experiments with the arrival of Japan's HTV-7 cargo spacecraft. HTV-7 launched to the station 5 days earlier from the Tanegashima Space Center in southern Japan. Preparations continue in Russia for the launch of the space station's next crew, Expedition 5758. On September 25th, our Nick Haig, cosmonaut Alexeyev Chenin of Roscosmos, and their backups boarded a bus in Star City for the trip to the Baikonur Cosmodrome launch site in Kazakhstan. Haig and Ovchinin will launch October 11th to begin a 6-month mission on the station. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.